So at the advent of the 80s, it became very clear, especially once MTV was going too. But even before that, it became very clear that you better be looking good, because the rock magazines were having these glossy, you know, what, 100-page magazines with, you know, every 2 or 3 pages would be another new band or a band that you've loved for years or so on and so forth. And the photography for these guys sometimes was just outrageous, and their outfits and everything like that. So it became real obvious that we better step our game up. We better get some good photos taken of us for these promotional, you know, possibilities. And we went with the guys that were the top guys, and if we can get them. And of course, some of the top guys at that time were Niels Lozauer and this Mark Weiss guy. these were the guys that, you know, we'd look at these photos in the magazines and you'd see the photo credit at the bottom of the picture, and a whole lot of them were from these two guys. And there were a few others as well, obviously. But that was the scene at the time, is that we had to not only have good clothes, we had to have the attitude, we had to have the makeup, we had to have the right lighting. And of course, who's going to do that but a pro photographer who really knows what he's doing and has the experience. And it became an essential part of making or breaking a band, certainly in the 80s. And that was with video and with still pictures.